Hey, good morning or good evening, everyone. This class, I will talk about how the site response analysis could help us to battle climate change. Yes, you heard this right. You know, we can do the site response analysis to reduce the seismic loading. So from that, we can, you know, cut the CO2 emission. Also, I will provide you the free evaluation for how to reach this goal. The ASCE 716 substantially changes the requirements for site response analysis. As you can see, all the cases in this red area right now, the code require you to do the site-specific response analysis. You know, if you know the 710 very well, that version, the site response analysis is only required for the site class F site. So right now, it appears for majority cases of site class D and E, you need a site response analysis. If you want to know the details of the changes, you can watch my other YouTube, ASC 716, changes on seismic ground motion values. So since this is a dramatic change, ASC 716 gives you exceptions for the requirement, since many of the structural or geotechnical firms, particularly in East Coast, they don't know how to do their site-specific response analysis. As what I demonstrate in my other YouTube videos, my recommendation is that you are better to do the site-specific response analysis for a project site with the site class E. So even the code give you the exception for that, you know, my recommendation is always do the site-specific response analysis for site class E. The good thing is that the site class E site is not that common, and the site class D site actually is the most common site for the projects. So the exception too is particularly for site class D. So if you interpret that exception, that was as the figure showing on the right hand side. So the black line, that will be basically the 710, the response spectral requirement. In the 716, if you don't do the site response analysis, you have to extend your plateau to 1.5 TS. And from that, you know, you will also extend the SD1 to 1.5 second. So because of that, you know, you will see there is a substantially seismic load increase for the period greater than TS. So typically, the TS value is around 0.5 to 0.6 seconds. It depends on your project site. So if you have a building with a fundamental period less than 0.5 seconds, basically maybe 5 to 7 story building, the seismic loading is not changed very much. However, if the fundamental period of building or structure is longer than TS, you would better do the site response analysis, you know, with the potential to reduce the loading to the green spectrum. That will be substantial saving for the project. I think one benefit for the green response spectrum, you know, actually is lower than the plateau used in the current code 710. So keep that in mind, you know, it can also, you know, even you can use this exception, it can also reduce the load for the peak as well. So this slide just show you a generic example. You know, if you have site class D, 100 feet soil with average survey velocity 900 feet per second, So if you don't do the site-specific response analysis, but relying on the exception to the red line, the dark red line, that will be the response spectrum. If you do the site-specific response analysis, follow the chapter 21, you will get the green line as your response spectrum. So there is about 20% no reduction for every period. And another thing you need to keep in mind, you know, this is a talk about a very generic case with 100 feet soil, but many areas in the U.S., they don't have exactly 100 feet soil. For example, like New York City, the soil depth is typically less than 50 feet. But if you go to Memphis and Seattle area, the soil depth is much more great than 1,000 feet. So all these soil columns will impact how the response spectrum looks like. And unfortunately, you know, the building code is trying to envelope all the cases for the design, so which means it's very conservative. So for those cases, I highly recommend you do the size response analysis to determine your seismic loading. Another reason you need to do site response analysis is ASCE 710 has a higher FPGA value for most site classes comparing to the ASCE 710. So basically the coefficients are provided in this table. Remember, you know, ASCE 710 already increase the PGA by 50%. So basically before 710, you can use the design earthquake PGA for the liquefaction analysis, but 710 change that to maximum considered earthquake. So roughly it's 1.5 times higher than the PGA from the design earthquake. So now, you know, the FPGA is even higher. So the consequence is a lot of locations in the U.S., maybe some place in the eastern U.S., they don't have liquefaction before. Now, because of the cold change, you have the liquefaction. Then, you know, liquefaction is a very severe problem for foundation design. You either use the deep foundation, pipe foundation, or you have to do the expensive ground improvement to mitigate the liquefaction for foundation design. The good news, you know, you can do the site response analysis. There is up to 20% reduction for the PGA used for the liquefaction analysis. So for this, you could eliminate liquefaction issue for your project. So again, you know, this slide is to summarize the potential benefits from site response analysis. You know, first, you have up to 20% seismic load reduction for both SS and S1. Because of you have no SS and S1, so that can, you know, in some cases might lower your seismic design category. For example, it could from seismic design category D to C. The benefit of that is you have a lot of saving for the seismic detailing. You don't need to do more detailing for the seismic design category. Another thing is what I said is that you can have up to 20% reduction for the PGA for liquefaction evaluation. So for that reason, you could, for the project, you might not need to have to use the deep foundation or do the ground improvement. So all of these are very, very expensive for foundation. So with all this benefit, you know, it depends on your project size. I would say it could be easily save thousands to millions of dollars. So how would this relate to the climate change? You know, if you look at the industry, because you need to use a fuel or the steel mill, use a fuel or to produce the steel. So average size, you know, 1.9 tons of carbon dioxide per ton of steel produced. You know, if you look at cement, the number is lower, but it's still kind of significant. So as what I said, you know, you do the site response analysis, that could reduce the seismic loading, and because of that reason, you will reduce the usage of steels and cements for your project, either the building or the manufacturer plane. So you save many tons of steels and cements. That will be equivalent to hundreds or thousands of tons of CO2. So from that way, you know, you can relate your daily work to this great emission to cut the CO2 emission. So again, you know, you might not to know how to do the site response analysis, you know, or for a project, you know, you might not to know whether, you know, the site response analysis actually reduce the loading for your project. So for that reason, I will provide you guys the free evaluation. Yes, free evaluation. So, you know, I know there is some confidential issue for your project. You don't need to tell me the project name, location. You just need to provide me the S1, SS, you know, what is the site cost for your project site, and some preliminary soil column information. So I will use kind of a little bit different approach with the building code, the random vibration method that doesn't need input motion. I can quickly evaluate your site. Once you do the site response analysis, what could be the site-specific response spectrum? Typically, in my experience, you will see about 10 to 20% low reduction. Remember, the 20% low reduction is a maximum allowed by the building code. So if you are interested, you feel free to contact me. You know, my email is on this slide. Just send me an email. Give me the basic project information as what I said. You know, I will, you know, return your email in 1 week. Just tell you what could be the benefit if you do the site response analysis. Well, again, thank you very much. I hope you have a great day.